Monty, you have been so instrumental in kind of pointing me in the right direction.
It was about looking at your character defects and spirituality.
It's the integration of clinical practices with the 12 steps.
It's an absolute pleasure. He certainly knows a lot of people. He's got a lot of energy. And sometimes when you don't have so much energy, he picks you up and carries you.
And the Monty man there certainly helps.
This is one of the places that is about the business of the solution.
The views expressed on this special broadcast of the Take 12 radio show do not necessarily reflect those of KHLT Recovery Broadcasting or its affiliates. KHLT is not affiliated with any particular 12-step fellowship.
Now here's that guy who's getting less popular minute by minute, your host, the Monty Man.
What are you guys up to? My goodness sakes, can you believe that Christmas is just around the corner? I mean, I got to tell you, it comes quicker every year. We say that every year. Lord have mercy. The holidays are not something that's a lot of fun for a lot of people in recovery. So let me encourage you. Let your heart not be troubled, because there is one who will never leave you or forsake you, and that is your Creator, and He loves you just the way you are. And if you are listening to this show today, and you have never stepped foot into the doors of any fellowship that has to do with recovery, 12-step or otherwise, and you are struggling like the dickens, especially this time of year, let me encourage you. Give it a chance. Would you please? You may be very surprised. We have resources here at take12radio.com on your internet dial. You can call us Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. And just go on the contact us link on our website at take12radio.com. Give us a call. We'll hook you up. We'll help you to make the first step. Hey, listen, this is such a cool show today. One of the things that is so exciting for me is to watch people cooperate with each other, people that are in media, cooperate with each other and drop the competition ball and realize that we're on the same side and help each other to share our experience, strength, and hope. To understand that anonymity does not mean secrecy, and it's the 12-Step Fellowship's public relations policy that's based on attraction rather than promotion, not people's personal stories. And it's amazing what is happening in our world today when it comes to recovery radio, and it's growing all the time. And we here at Take 12 Radio and KHLT Recovery Broadcasting just want you to know that we want to help influence, we want to encourage, and we want to come alongside of people that are doing such wonderful work. And one of those folks is a gentleman by the name of Malcolm Hicks. Now, some of you may recognize his name. Malcolm had a show called The Higher Power Hour, and we're going to talk about that and what's coming up for that, and maybe some of the ideas he's going to be presenting about that. But he also does another thing called Rockin Recovery Radio. Now, you know that we have 3-hour music sets of recovery recording artists. We have some other artists there too, but primarily that. But what about the folks who maybe they just don't want to listen to a bunch of recovery music one right after another? And, you know, maybe they'd like to tune into a station where they can hear a little Cat Stevens, they can hear a little Billy Joel, they can hear a little Aerosmith or whoever, some of their favorite recording artists, maybe Buddy Holly, I don't know. But they'd like to hear some of that, and they'd also like to get a flavor of recovery mixed in with that. Well, let me tell you, Rockin' Recovery Radio does just that. And Malcolm Hicks is our guest this week. Malcolm, welcome to Take 12 Radio, buddy.
It's a pleasure to be here, Monty. I've heard the show a bunch of times, and I'm excited what it is about what you do.
Well, you know, it's so good, like I said, that we're not in competition, that we support each other. And you've been doing this thing, you've been doing radio in general for how many years?
Well, let's see. I was in corporate radio for about 35 years, and then I finally made a leap of faith to jump out of corporate radio and pursue the dream, which was to bring a spiritually based recovery radio show to those that might be open to receiving such a medium.
Right.
And finally had an opportunity to do that.
But before we talk about rock and recovery, let's hit on the higher power hour for a minute. What was that all about? And what are your plans?
Well, the higher power hour basically is a story of, it's an hour long show that's basically a recovery oriented show, but it's more about the spirituality that's involved. And when I talk about spirituality, of course, I'm talking about higher power or whatever your concept of God is. And the idea behind the show was to bring a radio flavor in sort of a 60-minute music/recovery magazine and present it to people in a way that, in a format that they were easily familiar with and have them make the decisions if they're on the fence about recovery to help them make a decision about which way they want to go and to aid those who are already in recovery to solidify what their commitment to recovery is and to their higher power God. And give it that type of flavor with testimonials, of course, and mainstream music and Christian music and country music and recovery music and throw a whole bunch of flavors in there that fit and punctuate exactly what it is anyone may be talking about as far as the testimonials are concerned within the framework of that hour.
And so it really is. So we don't want people to freak out here because, you know, some people do. It really is all inclusive. The main thing is that you're helping to point people in a direction that has a spiritual basis to it, just like the steps do.
Absolutely. And the way that we do that, and you're right, because some people hear the word God and they get freaked out about it. And the show premise is basically that there's mainstream music, as I mentioned a little earlier, from all types of genres that we utilize.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to your favorite music and somebody comes in, they're talking about recovery. Well, there's two things that got you here if you're in the neighborhood of recovery. And one is that you're hearing your favorite song. The other is you're hearing somebody talk about recovery. And that might catch your ear for a little bit longer. And as you progress throughout the show, it's basically about, you know, what it's like, basically, and what got you here, and are you going to move any further in the direction that you might need to as far as recovery is concerned? So, again, the premise is basically, here's something that you can listen to, and in the privacy of your own mind, say as you're driving down the road or maybe in the comfort of your own home, you can make your own decisions about how you feel about the direction that you may decide to move in or not.
Right. Well, let's tell the listeners something about Malcolm, because you know how people are. They're like, well, you know, I don't know if I trust this guy. I don't know. Is he in recovery? Is he a recovered alcoholic or addict? Or what is his history? Things weren't always, you know, going as well as they are now for you in the past, right?
Well, I hope you're using that term going well loosely, because still going through the struggles, but
sure.
The difference is that when you're, and I'm sure you're aware of this too, that, you know, when you're living your dream, you're primarily focused on what it is that you can do to be able to facilitate that dream, and my dream pretty much involves recovery and service and God, so that's a win combination all around, and being able to present my radio skills in such a venue is an added bonus, because now I understand the vehicle in which I'm trying to transmit that kind of flavor to people who may be open to receiving some kind of word about, you know, a solution to their problem or the pain that they might be in.
Yeah.
And you're right. Things weren't always as good as they are now. In fact, in terms of financial and material things, they were a lot better in my past, but they didn't really fulfill what it was that I wanted to go towards. I've been in radio for about 35 years, and succeeded in reaching the apex of my career working in San Francisco at pretty much a lot of the top stations there, and didn't really find it too challenging after a while because there was a little something missing, and that was easy to go on and be a personality. But what I wanted was something a little bit more fulfilling, and that led me to getting involved with the ventures that I'm involved with now, the Higher Power Hour and Rock and Recovery Radio.
Right.
So I did the top 40 and all the, you know, the rounds in San Francisco, and came up in the bootstraps, started in San Jose, California, and worked in Sacramento, Spokane, and did a stint in Monterey, and the big league, San Francisco. So I accomplished all my goals, but you know, there was something a little lacking as far as the spiritual God-centered part.
You know what is so it's so amazing to me, and this happens more times than I can even remember. When it comes to the recovery community, I grew up in Petaluma, California. You're in Santa Rosa, California. So both Sonoma County guys. I was there for, a good part of my life. Graduated high school from there. I lived in Sacramento for a while. I lived in Seaside, which is right outside of Monterey. I never lived up in Washington, but I mean, there's so much, you got to wonder, in all the places that you travel throughout your life and the parties and the business meetings and the this and the that, the people you run into later on in years, if you haven't rubbed shoulders with them somewhere, it's just amazing. And it's so cool how God just kind of brings people together when it's the right time. And I just got to tell you, I'm so excited about our relationship because, who would have ever thought that you and I'd be talking? Although, like you said, you've been listening from a distance. I've been listening to you from a distance. I heard your interview with Joseph on Rum Radio. It's just a hoot, isn't it?
It is, especially when you realize how intertwined our paths are.
Yeah.
As far as the and the medium that we're involved in, I think I told you when we talked once before that some of the times that I was checking out your website, there was I'd look at all the stuff that was on your website. And I was going, how does he do that? It excited me that first of all you were able to bring that to the table. And then, listening to your show, it was like, wow, I have this dream that I want to do, but, will I really be able to pull it off like that? Because that seems huge at the time.
Yeah. 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 And then we shared off the air for the listener's sake here. We have some of the same frustrations. It's good to know that, we're just ordinary guys trying to trying to do this thing one day at a time.
Trying to bring a message.
Yeah, trying to carry that message, and it's so vital. The number one health threat in our nation, folks, is addiction, and yet it gets the least amount of attention because of the stigma. But recovery media is really doing something about that, and I think we're making some headway, Malcolm. I really do. We're going to take a break. And when we come back, let's talk more specifically about Rockin' Recovery Radio. And we're going to give the listeners a little sample of what you provide. Folks, don't go away. More with my guest, Malcolm Hicks from rockinrecovery.com when we come back.
As men and women who have recovered from utterly hopeless states of addiction ourselves, we know all too well what it's like to battle addiction daily. We are Origins Recovery Centers. Here at Origins, we have taken that which we have learned along the way, excised anything unhelpful and unnecessary, infused it with the latest medical research and innovative therapeutic methods, and created what we know to be the absolute gold standard in substance abuse treatment. And Origins provides the most preeminent aftercare and relapse prevention program available in the United States. For a free confidential clinical assessment, call toll-free 888-843-8935. That's 888-843-8935. Origins, delivering real solutions for real families.
Hey, it's Artie Kornfeld, and you're listening to Take 12 Radio, Recovery Talk, and Positive Music.
All right, and welcome back, everyone. Malcolm Hicks, if you're familiar with that name, the Higher Power Hour, which was on KSRO 1350 on Sunday evenings between 5 and 6, that website is still up, and there is a show playing there. Before we go into Rock and Recovery in detail, you've got some plans for Higher Power Hour, do you not?
Yes, we do. We have just recently, in fact, when we put up the Rock and Recovery music channel, the plan all along was to find a way that we could have a little bit more essence and a little bit more hands approach on it. And since we started the channel, we're moving the Higher Power Hour over from KSR Radio to a much more defined. Well, I guess the word would be new. So we've got Higher Power Hour on the Recovering Music Channel, which seems to be a good fit. And we'll be broadcasting that in the same time on Sundays at 5 o'clock. That will be Pacific time here in California. So, yeah, we're going to move it over from, in fact, we've already begun the process to produce new shows that will be airing, I suspect, sometime right after the first of the year.
Well, that's exciting. That's really exciting stuff. And what's great about the internet, you can say what you want to about the internet. We know there's a lot of evil out there. But what's so great about it, it is, you know, a person can go international. You know, the towers are coming down and the internet is moving forward. And
yeah.
That is so cool. That is just so cool. Okay.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
The way to get the message out there is come down to the level of well, the people just like you and I that have an internet connection and a couple of speakers, and we're able to do a lot of good out there.
Yeah, you bet. Okay, let's talk about rockinrecovery.com and Rock and Recovery Radio. This was not something you did right away. I mean, this came after Higher Power Hour, right?
Yeah, it's a labor of love, and you know, of course, the time that you spend percolating on things to try and make it better. And this was actually probably close to about a 20-year idea that just happened to take fruition.
Wow!
And get up off the ground within the last six months. I think we went on this year about six months ago for rockandrecovery.com. And the idea, the whole idea of it was to have a radio station that could deliver, that could bring recovery to a mainstream audience in a delivery system that they were already familiar with. And that would be radio, of course, and it would be in a format that would be for a specific niche. And that niche is recovery. And, you know, as you well know, there's a lot of music out there and a lot of content. And there are a lot of talk shows, and there's some music shows out there. And, you know, they're all headed in the same direction. And I really like what you said a little earlier, Monty, about it being the spirit of cooperation instead of competition.
Mm-hmm.
Because ultimately that's what's going to work, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So I decided finally to go for the guns. I had given up working for corporate radio and decided that I was just going to go out on my own and get this thing done because, you know, when it's coming from your heart speaks very loud and it says, you know what, this is something that you're going to do till you die. This is the direction that you're headed in. You know, this is all the cards are on the table, and let's go for it because, you know, you reach an age where you say, if I don't do this right now, I'm never going to do it.
That's right.
And even if I fail, you know, the satisfaction from being able to sit here and talk to you about it and open it up to the world at some level is worth that. So thank you for this chance. I really appreciate it.
Oh, absolutely, man. It's my honor. And folks, the website is Rockin Recovery. It's R-O-C-K-I-N recovery.com. Bookmark that thing, folks, and check it out. We're going to give the listeners a little bit of a sample of what they can expect to hear on Rockin Recovery Radio. So check this out, folks. Get that homecoming, better get that wood. Well, I quit those days and my redneck ways. Ooh, change is gonna do me good.
Just for today.
Rockin Recovery.
on the 27th of this month, I'll have 37 years of recovery. Believe me, there's a way out. I was in so much fear that it was hard to be in my own skin. But now I live in peace. There is a place where you can get up each day and have peace in your world.
The Recovery Music Channel. RockinRecovery.com.
So there is an example of what you will hear when you go to RockinRecovery.com. You'll just go there. The musical player will start up where it's at. And here's the cool thing. I don't know what Elton John was thinking when he wrote that song. I don't know what his heart was, what his focus was. But when you listen to the words of that song, which would be considered mainstream rock and roll, at least in our era, huh, Malcolm?
Yeah, let's go back a piece, huh?
You know, get back, honky cat. You know, and he's talking to me. I'm listening to this song, and I'm listening to the words, and I'm thinking, you know, I'm doing something different with my life now. I'm leaving the old stuff behind. There's lots of songs out there. I don't care what the artist, what they intended at the time. The message that a lot of us can receive can be really positive. One of the other songs that is You Belong to the City. Man, I was there. You and I talked about Tom Petty's song, Free Fallin'. I mean, when I was out on the streets, I'd listen to that song, and it was one of the things that made me hunger for some sort of normalcy. That kept my eyes on the prize, so to speak. Even though I was doing really horribly, it gave me some hope.
And that's what music does.
Yeah,
you know, it inspires you and it gives you hope. And when you talk about Elton John, it's funny at the time that he had no idea, I think, that he would be in recovery years later. So it adds a little bit more significance to the song. And who knows what it meant at the time? You know, it's a feel good song. It's reminiscent of a time, you know, long gone by. And you know, the older you get, and when you get in recovery, you look at songs in a different way. So maybe you hear them in a different way too.
Sure. You bet. Brian Duncan, who does our Thursday show, which is a 30-minute show where he mixes some of his personal experience, strength, and hope, along with some songs. He was at the peak of his career. He was receiving multi-Dove awards. He was with Sweet Comfort Band. He was the top of the Christian music charts, and nobody knew it, but he was dealing with addiction when he was at the pinnacle of his career, and he wrote music that later he realizes now that was definitely God inspired, that he had no idea would be used in recovery circles today and are.
It just absolutely
amazing stuff like that. It's so good. It's so good. Okay, so there's people sharing their experience, strength, and hope every so many songs. What are your plans for Rock and Recovery Radio as you go forward?
Well, the potential, the possibilities are endless. As many as, you know, I don't want to sound vague about this, but
sure.
But the ideas that of what you can do with a vehicle like this are just limitless. You can literally go any direction as far as bringing the message out, and you know, it has public possibilities getting out there in the public and
mm-hmm.
music festivals. You know, a foundation, you know, all these things are in the works for the future. And there's no shortage of ideas or people to integrate, you know, within
right.
the framework that they're using. So, you know, you mentioned Brian Duncan. You mentioned, you know, you also mentioned that, you know, the multitude of recovery artists out there that are putting out good music, great music, and it all fits. You know, our format basically is we play a little rock, we play a little country, play a little top 40, we play a little bit of Lady Gaga. I don't know how you could categorize.
But somebody who likes Lady Gaga might be tuning in and going, "Hey, I dig this," yeah. and then boom, recovery message.
Yeah,
yeah,
absolutely. But when you listen to her music, there's a couple of tunes that she's put out there that are so that reflect the society and what's going on in society right now.
That's right.
So then you've got the recovery music, then you've got Christian music. You know, there's a wide range of music now that is really speaking to what's going on in our lives today and reflective of what's happening in society. And so what we do is we just provide the vehicle to be able to move forward in that and to relate just like you and I are relating, and give people an opportunity to hear the message, you know, again, in a vehicle that they're already familiar with and already comfortable with, so that they can make decisions inside themselves without somebody pointing to them saying, you should do this, you should do that.
Right.
They get an opportunity to really feel it out, you know, internally and to make a decision, particularly those who are afflicted with the illness of alcoholism or substance abuse.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You bet. And, you know, nobody likes being told, you can't do this, you can do this, you can't do that, but you can do this, blah, blah, blah. And even though sometimes we need that, nobody likes that. And sometimes it takes some maturity and some growing up before we start receiving that stuff in a way that's palatable. So it's important that we are palatable for the newcomer. I mean, isn't that the most important person anyway? I mean, the guy just walking in the door that, you know, you could crush. Malcolm, when I walked into my particular 12-step support meeting, you could crush me with a word, brother. You know what I'm saying? You could wipe my world out. If somebody had came up to me and said, shut up and sit down, you have nothing to say, that would have killed me. Thank God that didn't happen to me. I walked into a room, a smoke-filled room, and it was definitely cigar smoke because it's a lot thicker. And this room was this narrow hallway kind of thing, and you had your table, and you had people sitting on both sides of the tables, but they could barely back up to get out of their chairs. It was so thin. And I'll never forget it, man. I walked in, and this old guy, he must have been 100 years old, you know, he says, kid, are you a drug addict? And I don't know what I am. He goes, well, this is a 12-step meeting, and you're in the right place because you don't know what you're doing. So sit down and I'll give you some coffee, man. And he just had that rough voice, you know, but he was kind. He was considerate. He didn't tell me I didn't have anything to share. He was pleasant. It definitely was a case of attraction. So I went back. And the more I went back, the more I heard what I needed to do. And you know, I'm going to say this, and anybody that listens to my show isn't going to be surprised by that. Today's 12-step support meetings have lost a lot of the depth and the intentions of what the founders of the mothership AA had intended. We've become very man-centered, and in our attempt to please everyone. There is a way to be very higher power, creator centered, to be very focused on the spiritual without being man centered. And I think that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to bring it back. So, no, it's not our intention. It's not your intention or my intention or Joseph Gansey or from Rum Radio or any of these guys' intentions to offend anyone, although we will sometimes. What we want to do is we want to make it palatable so they'll keep coming back, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that this is a perfect medium for us to be able to bring that to the table, particularly the way that, the various formats of being able to do so are constructed. You know, like you were talking about Joseph Gansey. You know, I was just listening to him the other night. And your shows and the many other multitude of shows that are out there too that are trying to attack this illness from a bunch of different ways but heading in the same direction, and the big thing that I get is that they're all talking about a spiritual connection,
yeah,
you know, and not necessarily trying to hammer it
right
into your head with a 2x4. Although I will say that some folks need that. I was one of those people that kind of needed that after a while.
Yeah.
But you know, giving it to us in a way that we can absorb it, or as Bill Wilson that put so aptly in the in that big blue book, that it's of the education. educational variety, which some people have an opportunity to enjoy over a period of time, instead of expecting to get that lightning bolt experience that other people seem to want you to have just because maybe they had it.
Sure.
There's a big difference.
Yeah. It didn't happen to me like that. I turned my will in my life over to the care of God. It was not anything exciting, that's for sure.
Yeah.
I would have loved to have a white light Bill Wilson experience. That would have been really cool. But, you know, sometimes sometimes I wonder, though, you know. I mean, if you watch Cecil B. DeMille's The Ten Commandments, you know, Moses comes down off the mountain and his face has got the Shekinah glory of God on him. And here are these people, these Israelites, that have been saying for years, God, show us your face. And then when he did, what do? Don't look at us. Go away. So sometimes I wonder if God came down in all his glory and said, here I am, man. I don't think that would necessarily do it for a lot of people. You know, we want proof and then we're given it and then we kind of go, eh. You know, I think we have to experience it ourselves, and everybody's an individual, and we want to make sure that we allow people to be who they are, right?
Yeah. And I think under that framework, they're much more open to receiving that information.
Yeah, you bet.
You know, I was the same way. You know, my first meeting, you know, I didn't know that I was going to wind up there, first of all, so I know that was divinely inspired. But after I was there, I recognized that my thoughts and my feelings had changed. I hadn't thought about, you know, taking myself out or taking anybody else out. And, you know, and I was at peace, and I couldn't tell you why, but I knew that maybe I need to come back again and see if I can get a, you know, get a finger on this and figure out what it's all about. And
yeah.
And that first meeting, I've been coming back ever since, you know, and pursuing recovery and a belief system of faith that I know that I can count on.
Yeah, right on, buddy. Right on. Folks, we're going to be right back after this, more with my guest, Malcolm Hicks, Higher Power Hour, Rockin' Recovery Radio. What a treat to have Malcolm on with us. Don't go away.
This is Chris Schroeder. You are listening to Take12Radio.com, recovery talk and positive music.
You and I know all too well how talented folks in recovery are. KHLT Broadcasting, the Take 12 Recovery Radio Show, and the Recovery Broadcasting Network are handing you the opportunity to share some of that talent. If you've ever written your own songs and have always wanted to share them publicly, here's the chance to share your talent with thousands of people all over the world through internet radio. For the next several months, the Monty Man will be reviewing songs written and performed by people in recovery. Whether you're an accomplished musician or a novice, he wants to hear from you. All forms of music will be considered. Adhering to federal copyright laws and possible contractual agreements, some restrictions may apply.
And that's right. And please, folks, when you send it, no cassette tapes, please. I've had to join the age of technology and leave my cassette players in the dust. I'm sorry. but they just seem to get busted up in the mail. So we do take MP3. You know, you can go to submit your music on our webpage at take12radio.com. But we would appreciate it if you have a CD to send us a CD. It's much easier for us. And I have to tell you, because I've had a few emails, you don't get those back, and we don't get to everyone. You know what, Malcolm? I remember when CDs first came out, and my brother-in-law had like 3. And I thought, wow, I want to have 3. And I'm buried in them. And I'm like, gee, willikers.
I know that feeling well.
Yeah, I'll bet you do. I'll bet you do. Okay, let me ask you this. You've been in radio a lot longer than I have. I started this thing 9 years ago. I swore up and down I was never going to get on a computer. They didn't scare me or anything like that. I just didn't want to do it. And then I ended up having a job where I had to learn how to do credit checks and stuff. And back in the days of the blue screen, right? And and then I got hooked, you know. And Take 12 Radio is something that was birthed out of my experience with a computer. And
amazing.
Yeah, it just blows my mind. So I've only been doing this thing for 9 years. And before that, I've got a loud mouth and a lot of opinions. And, you know, I pretty much stick to my guns with how I feel about things. And so forth.
Great.
Huh?
But you sound great.
Oh, well, thank you. You do too. You've got that deep voice, man, that's just so awesome. You know, that's that radio. I wish I had that voice, you know, for radio.
You know what, Monty, that's probably one of the biggest fallacies in radio.
Like, is that right?
I'm thankful that it's one of the tools that I use to be able to bring the message. But you know what a broadcaster told me years ago, and it's a guy that I really, really respected, and you grew up in the Bay Area, so you know what I'm talking about, a fellow by the name of John McFlanagan. He used to be on KFRC.
KFRC, you bet.
And Bob Anthony, you know, who used to be a KFRC.
But right.
John McFlanagan was the guy that I used to talk to all the time. And as I remember it, he was the fellow that told me he had a great voice, knew how to use the microphone. But he said the idea is to get inside people's heads.
Yeah.
And you and I both know when we say the theater of the mind, that's paramount. So,
mm-hmm.
You know, it's not really necessary for you to have a great voice.
Right.
But if you can get in somebody's head, and he said you've got 8 seconds. When that commercial is over or after that record is over, to say something that's going to keep people around, where you have to exercise, you know, whatever skills that you have to get inside their head to keep them coming back. And where have we heard that before?
Yeah. Well, you know, it is so true. Because you look at people like Michael Savage. What a horrible voice. You know, Dr. Demento. Are you kidding me? You know, and some of these guys, you're right. Some Andy Rooney, you know, Howard Stern. I mean, come on. And yet, you know, they do so well what they do. It just amazes me. So, I've had over the 9 years, I've had several people ask me, what are some of the pitfalls of doing this stuff? Or what are some of the roadblocks? Or what have you experienced, Malcolm, in doing this recovery radio thing? Have you come across some barriers?
You know, it's very interesting that you said that, because after we talked, what was it, last night or a couple of nights ago?
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you, folks, talking to Monty is a real experience, because we were on the phone for about 2 good hours.
I know.
But having a great time. But, you know, it's interesting that you said that, because I woke up this morning and I got on my computer and I was going through stuff that I usually do to check to see if there's anything that I can use. A lot of stuff that came up was about negative experiences that keeps you from realizing your goals. Now, a lot of people would say, well, my goals ultimately are to be financially successful. I kind of look at it in a different way now.
Mm-hmm.
And, I've reframed that to be satisfied with the direction that I'm going, and also to have peace of mind around the direction that I'm going. And what I find is that every person that has a dream has to find people of like mind, people that will support you and that will love you while you're pursuing that dream. And you're going to come across a lot of people that won't see it, and you have two choices. You know, there'll be a lot of negativity. People say, well, you know, it'll never do this. You know, it'll never happen for you. And maybe they're thinking in terms of monetary success, but that may not be the end game, you know. And what I found in my experience is that a lot of people, because they haven't had a dream worth really pursuing in their own lives, will tend to put up a lot of barriers and obstacles for you to consider in your life. You know, oh, that'll never happen, or well, what about this, what about that? And when I got on the Internet this morning, I was reading some information about a fellow. I can't think of his name. I think his name is Steve Toback. That writes for Entrepreneur Magazine, and he talked about how people who have a lack of money are a little bit more creative in their approaches to marketing and the way that they utilize their talents to make that dream happen, so that when money does become available, it's a drop in the bucket. You know, they really don't concentrate on having it. They concentrate on getting the task at hand done. And So those are the external forces out there, the people who will always say, no, it'll never happen. And then, you know, sometimes it'll bring you down. And then other times you have to realize, well, they're not doing what I'm doing, you know.
Right.
And then the other barrier is yourself, of course. You know, the little demons, the little friendly demons, the little not-so-friendly demons that when you wake up in the morning, you go, oh, my God, how am I going to get through this day and do what it is that I want to do, you know? And then you have to work your way through it, you know? When you get on the Internet and you hear other people out there doing the same thing, you know, for instance, you, and I know I'm giving you a lot of credit, and you deserve it, man, and all the other people out there that are doing
bless your heart
radio, because you know that those people are vested in it. You know the behind-the-scenes stuff, the effort that it takes to be able to put together a show when you know that there's an uphill battle to fight as far as recovery is concerned in the mainstream public and the stigmas that are attached to that.
Yeah.
So it really is a massive undertaking that we're doing here in recovery radio. And to be able to get up every day and say, you know what, I believe, you have to keep telling yourself, and you have to have faith, biggest deal of all, because those negative influences, man, that are way back in my subconscious are always itching to come out and say, nah, it's not going to happen. But it does.
Yeah.
One day at a time.
Oh, boy, you said it so well, because, yeah, some days you wake up and you go, Bette Midler said it so well in The Rose. Is anybody out there?
Yeah, you
wonder, you know, and you know, and if they're just because you got a lot of clicks, or just because you got a lot of click throughs on your email marketing thing and all that stuff, you don't know what they're doing in front of their PC, smartphone, or their even their car. You don't know if they're really paying attention, and then it seems this is what happens to me. I'll get to a place where I'm like, oh my gosh, what am I doing? Am I nuts? You know, and I'll get an email or I'll get a phone call from somebody that'll say, and I got one of these not too long ago. I listened to an archived show of yours, and the guest you had on, what they said stopped me in my tracks, and I didn't take my life that night.
Wow.
And you know, and you hear something like that, and you know, then my wife tells me, she says, "See, you got to quit your whining, Monty."
then you know exactly what we're talking about. Talking about, because I had an experience like that myself, and it was on a day where I thought, you know, what am I doing this for?
No.
And it happened exactly at the time. You know, I like to say to people who I'm involved with, and who I mentor and sponsor and stuff like that, you know, God always shows up. And I'm the same for you. He always shows up in the 11th hour. But for me, it's like 11 o'clock, 11 p.m., 59 minutes and 59 seconds, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's so hard for me to just wade through those last few nanoseconds. And I've never been without.
Yeah.
That's concerned.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, I wonder where our next meal's coming from, but I look around and nobody in my family has lost a pound. Oh, my goodness sakes. Oh, boy. Well, Malcolm, this has been so great to have you on, and I look forward to our relationship and how that's going to, you know, I'm not sure what that looks like yet. I know you're not either, but I know that we're on the same side. And folks, you got go to rockinrecovery.com, R-O-C-K-I-N, recovery.com, and grow along with Malcolm in this thing and watch it unfold. I mean, it's amazing. I look back where we were 9 years ago, and I look where we're at today, and it just blows my mind, you know. And it's not by any amount of major enthusiasm on my part, because I get discouraged more than I feel encouraged. It's just, you know, God is so good, isn't he, Malcolm?
Absolutely. Yeah, and you know something, without God, you wouldn't be on a mission. And I hear in your voice, you're on a mission.
Yeah.
As well as other folks that are pursuing the same path. And that's a good thing. That's a real good thing.
Yeah, yeah. Malcolm, how can folks get a hold of you?
Very easily. If you go to the website, rockinrecovery.com, you can reach me at info@rockinrecovery.com. You can also get a hold of me on our Facebook page, and you can follow us on Twitter, too, @rockinrecovered on Twitter. So those are the three vehicles that you can get a hold of me at. And we're accessible. That's the cool thing about Recovery Radio. We're accessible.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You bet. We are taking over social media, by golly, by George. yeah, right on. Okay, and you can follow the links, folks, here at take12radio.com also for Rock and Recovery. We're going to close out. I like to do this sometimes. We do it on all of our Wednesday shows. I don't always do it on the other shows, but because we're talking about music that, you know, a person can take from that some real deep spiritual truths and apply that to their recovery. And many times artists don't even realize who they're reaching. And they will tell you that themselves. They'll think, wow, I had no idea somebody would interpret it that way. That's wonderful. One of the greatest compliments a recording artist can get, and I've heard them say this, many of them, is that when someone says, wow, I interpreted your song this way, and they had no idea that's how it came across. They really like that. So this song is by Laszlo Bain is the group. The lead singer is Chad Fisher. And this comes from their album All the Time in the World. And this is a song that was used reluctantly. Fisher did not want to do this, and then he had a change of heart. It was a theme song to the television show Scrubs. And when I first heard this, I thought, there's something about that song. I got to hear this whole thing. And then I found the studio mix for the TV show, and then I found the original song from their album. And we're going to play the original song from their album. Folks, listen to the words to this. It talks about technology, about being, you know, being plugged into the wall, meaning your Ethernet cable. It talks about some of the superficial stuff that we're looking for fulfillment in. And the main thing it talks about is the artist is saying, I can't do life on my own. I can't do it on my own. And I think you'll enjoy this. You may have never listened to this song this way before, so I encourage you to do this. And then we'll come back and we'll sign off. Here is a Laszlo Bain, Chad Fisher singing Superman.
Just in time, head down the 405. Gotta meet the new boss by 8 a.m. The phone rings in the car. The wife is working hard. She's running late tonight again. Well, I know what I've been told. You gotta work to feed the soul. But I can't do this all. Superman, I'm no Superman. You've got your love online, you think you're doing fine, but you're just plugged into the wall. And that deck of tarot cards won't get you very far. Superman, I'm no Superman. finish line. Won the race but lost your mind. Was it worth it after all?
Chad Fisher, Laszlo Bane, from their album All the Time in the World, entitled Superman. And you see what I mean, Malcolm? Isn't that powerful?
Like that. Like that one a lot.
It amazes. It gives me goosebumps because I've been there, man. I have put all my energy into being plugged into the wall one way or another, whether it was my iPhone or my well, I don't want to date myself. And what were those cassette players called that we used to carry around?
It's funny you say that now, because I'm going to find myself, I'm going to have to buy a tablet because it's doing everything that my desktop is doing now. And I got rid of my cell phone about 10 years ago, so I'm going to have to start exploring that again.
Oh, my God. Walkmans. That's what I was thinking of, Walkmans.
I remember those.
Yeah, yeah. And so, you know, this is the kind of stuff you can hear on Rockin' Recovery Radio. It's songs that you may be familiar with that have a message that may or may not have been intended by the artist, but man, you know, God sees the whole picture, and he has such wonderful things for us listeners in store for us every day. And he really does. One of the things that I do, Malcolm, when I work with somebody, when I sponsor somebody, is I have them make a gratitude list, and they have to make a list of 30 things they're grateful for, and they can't be associated with each other. And that can be a little hard. But one of the greatest things I got back from Guy was, he says, I am thankful for peanut butter. Because for 4 years of his life, that's what he had to live on the streets.
Yeah.
And it's good stuff, man. God takes care of us. Malcolm, any last words, buddy?
Well, what can I say? I'm grateful for the opportunity to sit and talk with you for the past hour and to exchange ideas. And hopefully we've made, for those that are on the fence, maybe you're exploring getting into recovery. Maybe you're in recovery, and we've just helped to be a foundation in your recovery as well. If there were any last words that I would have to say, probably would be keep on doing what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And keep coming back, because I've had a great time here this afternoon, and I hope those who are listening, our listeners are, that they get what they need. That would probably be it.
You bet. Well, thank you so much for spending this time with us. Don't hang up, Malcolm. I want to chat with you afterwards off the air. Folks, again, the website is Rockin' Recovery, R-O-C-K-I-N, recovery.com. It's Rockin' Recovery Radio. Malcolm Hicks has been our guest. Check it out. Put it on while you're doing your homework. Put it on while you're just sitting around. I mean, you guys can't tell me you don't just sit around once in a while. I've been around the recovery circles long enough to know that we do a lot of sitting around sometimes. And you know what they say about being alone in your head. Maybe you should welcome some of this Rockin' Recovery Radio in there so you can get some encouragement. So I really encourage you to do that. You can follow the links to get a hold of Malcolm here at take12radio.com on your internet dial. Don't forget our email address.
take12radio@comcast.net. Until our next broadcast, this is the Monty Man, along with my guest, Malcolm Hicks, and we're wishing God's perfect serenity for you. Bye-bye now.
This has been a broadcast of KHLT Recovery Broadcasting.
Ooh, kitty, 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 kitty.